Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry. Be happy.
Hi, welcome to Hoop-De-Doo, and welcome to the return of the Hooping Contender. This will be round 12, and the tutorial is behind the back spins. This is a very difficult move, but once you get it, it's kind of fun in an odd sort of way because you're twisting your arms and your shoulders and sometimes it hurts. So if you have any pain or you have any shoulder problems, you might want to take a few days off of this one and just take it a little bit at a time. Okay, so I'm going to start with the beginning and the end, and then I'll fill in the middle as we go. Okay, so to start with, you're going to be spinning the hoops, one in each hand, and you have to know how to spin the hoops. One in each hand in the reverse direction. So the hoops are going that direction, okay, if I'm facing this way. Okay, so, and you want to wind up with the hoops still spinning in the reverse direction, but both hands will be behind your back. Okay, so it'll look something like that. Okay, so first you have to know how to spin the hoops in the reverse direction. Okay, then after you learn that, we're going to take one hoop at a time, and we'll start with the left hoop, and I'll turn this way so you can see the beginning part of it. Okay, so what you're going to do is you have to somehow get this left hoop over to the right side of your body. So what you're going to do is you're going to take the hoop and bring it around to the back. Okay, and in order to do this move, you see the hand, the left hand is crossed in the back. So when the right hand comes around, it'll be crossed on top of the left one. So the left hand is going to have to learn how to spin behind the back. So if you notice my fingers, they're pointing straight out away from my body, and that's what keeps the hoop in its plane. And it's real important on this move to keep the hoop in plane. Okay? And because if you don't, you'll get hit in the head and everywhere else. Okay, so this is the way you spin it behind your back. And it takes a lot of practice. You can just start it standing still and just give it a push with your thumb. Okay? And this is what it looks like. So your hand will be like that. And after you get the other arm crossed over and back, then you want to make sure before you do that, that this hoop is going to be spinning as far away from the palm of your hand as you can. And basically, you're going to be these knuckles here, the hoop is going to be closer to the edge of your fingers, as you can see. That way, it'll give you more room to for the hoops so they don't hit your body. I don't have arms long enough to stretch that far, but maybe some of you might, and you might not have that problem. But that was the biggest problem for me. The hoops kept hitting me in the side of my body or my head or wherever. So I figured out that if you take and put the hoop as close to your fingertips as possible while spinning, and then of course you have more probability of the hoop spinning off your hand. Okay, so sort of you got to practice that and get the feel of it. So you've got the hoop, the left hoop, okay, and it is spinning in the reverse direction, and we're going to bring it over to the right side. Okay, so we're going to just bring it over, and it requires a hand position change after you get there, after you get to the other side. You're spinning the hoop, and you're going to bring it back. Okay, I just take it bit by bit, one little step at a time. So you're going to bring it back. This is the hand, okay, and it's going to come down back to the other side, and I'll show you from the other side too. And then when it gets to the other side, it's going to, you've got your hand in this position here, and you're going to at that point do your hand position change and then start it spinning. Okay, I'll show you from the right side, so that when it gets there, it gets to be a little bit confusing too as to which side am I doing now. But okay, so it's on the left side now, and we're going to bring it back, bring it down to the right side, and you've got your hand that needs to change now, so it's going to change position and start spinning. Okay, now when you're doing that with the left hand, the right hand, the hoop in the right hand, as we're starting, it's going to switch to the left side at the same time that the left hoop switches to the right side. So you're spinning it in reverse, the right hoop, going to wind up on the left side, and you just do the same thing that you did with the left hoop going behind you, but the right hoop is going to go in front of you. And same thing, it's spinning at your side. You're going to grab the hoop, bring it up, almost like you were going to go into a reverse weave, but you get it up here to your left side, and then you do your hand position change. And you can bring it down, down closer to where the other arm is going to be behind you. And it's always good, if you're working on one hoop, to have the other hoop in the position where it's going to be. It may not be moving, but if it's there, then it reminds you and your body and your brain that that hoop is going to be in action very soon. Okay, so you've got the right hoop, got the right hoop going in reverse, and we're going to bring it up, up, and do the hand change position. And it's going still in the reverse direction. Okay? So it's just going from one side to the other, right side to left side, with the right arm. Okay? So what you're going to do when you put them together is you've got the two hoops going in reverse direction, and you're going to now bring the right hoop to the left side in front of you, and the left hoop to the right side in back of you. Okay, so here we go. And you just do those two moves, put them together and do them at the same time. So one, two, three, go. And it really takes some thinking about it. Okay, let me show you from the front. You've got the two hoops going in reverse, and you're going to switch right hoop to left side, left hoop to right side behind you. Okay, that's what it looks like from the front. Let's see what it looks like from the back. Sure, I'm still on the camera. So reverse direction, and here we go. Okay, so what you have is this arm that's behind you. Now, you have the correct position for that hand. Now the problem is, how do I get the other hand back there and crossed? Okay, so the way you do it is, and we'll practice this with one hoop, the right hoop, and I would suggest your dominant hand doing this side. Or if you're left-handed, you can just make everything the opposite. But if you're right-handed, the hoop on the right side, you're going to want it to do all of the hard work. It's going to do the hardest part of the whole move. Okay? So we will practice it with this hoop, the right hoop, and the other hoop just here crossed behind. And when we finish, the right hoop will be crossed behind also. Okay? So the left hoop is already in position. Let's pretend that it's spinning. So you want it here so that you can see what you're doing. Okay, and so your body will know that it's going to be in action really soon. Okay, so you've got the right hoop. Remember how we had, I'll show you from the front. Remember how we have it in the front. It's crossed over our body to the left side, and the left hoop is in that behind me. My arm is behind me, and the left hoop is on the right side. Okay, so the right hand has to come up and over your head to go behind you. Okay, and I'll show you from the side first because I think it's a little bit easier to see it from the side. We're going to bring it up and behind us, and then keep it spinning. So you can see behind me, okay, that's what it looks like. The right arm is crossed over on top of the left arm because it is the last arm to go back behind your back. The left hoop goes first and then the right one, okay? So here we go. And what you do is, it is a spin and it's almost like all the way up and back and behind your back. It's a spin that stalls each time you twist your arm. Okay, let me show you from the back. Here it comes. It's coming. Spinning, spinning, spinning. And the hand stays inside the hoop. No hand changes, none at all on this side. It comes up. So you notice how my hand stopped inside the hoop and sort of stalls, almost like an isolation. Okay, so let's see it from this side. So you're spinning, your hand is in the hoop, stays inside the hoop the whole time. Up. Okay, and it continues to spin. So at each point of the lift, or whatever you want to call it, the move to the back, at each point up, you see how my hand sort of stops the spin as it's going up. Okay, it sort of stops it. Not stop, but it pauses it. So that you're not actually spinning the hoop until it comes back down to your left side. Okay, so you practice that. Practice just one hoop at a time. Practice just the right hoop. And if you can't even do it holding the left hoop behind your back while doing it, then lay it down and just do it one step at a time. If you can, put your arm behind your back with or without the hoop. You just take it baby steps on this one. You work on one step at a time. When you get that, then you go to the next step. Okay, so you're coming up and down. Okay, and from the side. Okay, so you're going spinning, 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 up, behind you, and back. Okay, a good way to practice this is just to practice going behind your back with both hoops. And that will give you pretty good practice. Okay, so you've got your hand Your left hand now is going to go behind you. And anytime you do it going from your side to behind you, then you have to do a hand change after you get over to this other side. Anytime you're changing sides, there's going to be a hand change involved. If you're not changing sides, like the right hoop, when it comes, it's not really changing sides. You're twisting your arm. See that? There's a difference, and it's staying on the left side. Okay, it's just going from the front to the back, so there's no hand change. Okay. Only if you're changing sides. And that goes for any moves you're doing. Okay. So you've got it going in the opposite or in the reverse direction. You bring it back over and you've got it spinning. Okay. So just practice that. Practice getting the hoop either to the front of you. That was a hand change because you're going from one side to the other. Practice going, changing the sides in front and in the back. Okay. And another thing, if you can spin in front of you, then you turn your body and the hoop is beside you. Then if you turn your body again, and you want to make sure that your fingers, whichever direction your fingers are pointed, that's where the hoop is going to stay in that plane. Okay, so if you want the hoop to stay spinning in front of you, your fingers, my fingers, are pointed right at you, at the camera. If you want the hoop to be beside you, watch the fingers. They stay pointed at the camera. Okay, if I want it behind me, I'm just turning my body, but I want to leave my fingers there. So in order to leave your fingers there and turn your body to the back, you have to turn your arm and move your arm in an awkward position. Okay, so you notice the fingers, they stay pointing. So it's a move that goes from the side to the back. Side to the back. And that's a good way to practice because it's the same move that you're doing when you're coming up over. Okay? When you're coming up over and back to the other side. It's the same thing. You're moving your arm up, back, and around. And that's the same thing you do when you've got the hoop beside you and you turn your back, okay? Your arm is twisting, okay? Not the hoop and not your fingers, okay? So it's the same idea on this. Same idea. And that's probably the hardest part. And the hardest part comes, and the most frustrating part is when you actually get there, you've got the left one in behind you. And when you get there, to keep it spinning and without getting hit in the head and all that. Okay. And if you mess up, which you probably will quite a bit, maybe you won't, I don't know. I messed up quite a bit, still do, because it's very difficult. Okay, so you want to make sure that when you get the other one around to the back, and this is what it looks like when you've got it. Okay, when you get that one, the last one, back to the back, make sure that you focus on when it's coming up over your head and coming up. Make sure that you're focusing your brain on clearing the hoop that's already there spinning, because it will be spinning already. Okay, and you have to. It helped me to turn on music to sort of get the rhythm to know when this hoop that's already spinning is ready for me to do it. Okay. Because you have to lift your arm high enough to clear that hoop, to clear the hoop that's over on this side. Okay, and then when you get it there, then you have to really focus on keeping this hoop that you just put over. You have to focus on the same problem with the other hoop of making sure that the hoop is out far enough on your fingers so that it doesn't crash into your body. So you have a lot to think about as you're moving this hoop up and over. Okay, I've got to keep it spinning when it lands over to this side. And when you do it a lot, what you'll find is that the hoop in the left hand that's always spinning, you'll find that when you lift this other hand up, the hoop in the right and the left hand will stop spinning. And because you're so focused on getting this other hoop up and over and back, that it's too much for the brain. At least it was too much for my brain. Once your body gets used to the movement, the rhythm of it, it does have a rhythm, and your timing has to be almost perfect in order to pull it off. But once you get that, it will become easier. I'm doing it with quite a bit heavier hoops. These are not Polypro. They're just regular irrigation tubing. So they're a lot heavier than what I'm used to, but I didn't have anything color-wise that would show up for you to see. So try it with a little bit lighter hoops, but you want to really have some sort of tape on the hoops that's going to help you with the friction. I use athletic tape, which really helps you to hold on to the hoops, especially when you're bringing this one up over and bringing it back down, and then you got to start spinning immediately. Okay, so it helps to have athletic tape. The gaffer tape tends to get too heavy, and it also tends to not be as much friction with it as the athletic tape. You can get it at Dick's Sporting Goods, and I use it all the time because it helps me because of the osteoporosis too. Okay, so those are just my recommendations, and I usually use my Polypro hoops to do this, and they have athletic tape on them. Okay, and they're a little bit lighter weight, easier on your shoulders. Okay, and that's what you want for this move. You want something that's a little bit easier on your body, okay, because it's going to be hard, and you don't want to do it all in one thing. Okay, so with the lighter hoop, it's a little bit easier. Okay, so try different things, and you'll find what works best for you. If you have any questions, or you have a video that you want me to look at and help you troubleshoot, I would be more than happy to. Okay, so please let me know, and have fun with this one. Have patience with yourself, because this is a really difficult move. Okay, thanks for watching.